Greetings, commanders. Roy here. So today we are going to have a look at the start menu and the taskbar. Let me first start by saying that when you are working on a development machine that you intend to create a Linux bin, it's a good idea to make a backup of your virtual machine when it is like in a good state, just in case you F it up. So for that reason, we'll go in and we'll say clone in VirtualBox. And you can just give it any name. We'll just call it clone. And we just leave everything as it is. And next, full clone, finish. Then it's going to copy your machine. And it'll take just a few seconds. Make sure you have enough hard drive space for that. It literally copies the machine. So now we have a clone here, so we can always reverse to it later if something bad happens. Okay, so let's go to this one and start it. So as you can see, there's actually a lot of clutter going on here, like different programs that are like open when you log in. And I believe, let's go into full screen, control F. I believe this is related with when you have, say, logout. Yeah, when this one is ticked, then it will attempt to always save any program that even was recently open. I'm not really sure, but I really like to untick this one. And actually, in the final Commander Linux version, it will not even be here, this one. So just untick it and click cancel, and then just close all this clutter. By the way, in this regard, you definitely also want to go to the settings. Session and startup, go to save sessions and clear it. But we're not going to see that next time. Okay. Now, when XFCE is installed, by default, it creates two menus. It creates the one on top here, and then it creates this launcher menu on the bottom. Now, Commander Linux does not use a launcher menu, and this menu is at the bottom side. So we'll just click on anywhere here, click on panel and panel preferences. Then make sure the panel 2 is selected, and we'll click on the minus to remove it, click remove. Okay. Then we will untick the lock panel so that we can now grab on this handle here. And pull it down like that, and then we can lock it again. Now, the Commander Linux taskbar is a bit higher than this. It is exactly 44 pixels. Maybe we change that. And by the way, you can always go to your host machine and say panel preferences, and you can see the original values there. So let's go to the next tab. Yeah, Debian has a dark mode, and the Commander Linux theme does not have a dark mode yet. And sorry about that. We're gonna have to work on that one. For now, let's just turn off the dark mode. And we are going to use a background image for the taskbar, but that will be in the next episode, because that is part of installing and configuring the theme. So we'll get back to that. Now, fixed icon size. We look at the host machine. You can see that here they are set to 32. but we'll change it to the same here. Okay, so you can see the icons increase in size, except for this little culprit here, but we'll get back to that. And by the way, please note that when I hover, I get these tooltips, like from the volume, from the, it's the power manager, the notifications, the clock. But this little bugger, only for this one, the tooltip goes under the screen. That's what I was talking about in the first video, that there's a flaw in GTK 3 that makes the tooltip, but just for this guy here, for the network manager, to go under the screen, outside the screen. So we're going to have to fix that flaw, and we'll do that in a future video. Okay, so now let's go to the items. And by default, XFCE uses the application menu, this one. But this is not the one we use. We use the whisker menu. So if we click on add, scroll down, we'll find it here. We'll say add. And as you can see, it appears on the bottom right side of the taskbar. So now we can actually right click it, say move, and you can pull it over there. Let's just close here, and we will remove our applications menu as we don't need that anymore. Okay, so now we're going to right click on the menu, and we are going to configure it in the same way as this one is configured. So the only difference on this tab is the application icon size and category icon size should be normal and small. Let's have a look at that. Application icon size here, and category icon size here. If we change that to normal, it's small. That's a more appropriate size, I think. So let's go to the next tab, the appearance. And if we compare it to our host machine, we can see that we are using these three position categories next to panel button, this and this. Now let's check out what they do. Category next to panel button. So right now the categories are on the right side. I think it is more intuitive that they are on the left side. And the second one, position search entry, this one next to the panel button. So it goes to the bottom here. And the final one, position commands, these guys here, next to the search entry. So now they are here. Okay. And the profile picture, which is this one here, we use a square picture. Okay, but this one is round. And then we want to display icon and title. And the title should be start. And the icon, which we brought in last time in the last video from the Commander icon set, the Commander. This one. Okay. Let's double check this. Yep, it's all the same. So let's see behavior. People category is favorites. Yes. Switch categories by hovering. Yes, we want to do that. Favorites will get it done. Recently used, amount of items zero. We don't use recently used, and we don't include favorites. So let's go ahead and do that. Switch categories from hovering. Yes. And then the recently used here, we will put it to zero and remove this one. And now recently used is gone in the menu. Go to the next one. So these are the functions. These guys here. And as we can see, we are using restart and shutdown and not lock screen. Lock screen. So we'll turn this off. Restart and shut down. And there we go. Now we are almost identical to this one. Okay. And the final tab. Yeah, this is just standard stuff. We go here, we'll see it's exactly the same. So this is good. So by default, XFCE installs these like virtual desktops, like workspaces, where you can, you know, like have different screen setups in order to save space. But Commodore Linux doesn't use that, so we are going to remove it. So panel, panel preferences, and items. We've got this workspace switcher. We'll remove that one. Then we'll also remove this separator here. Okay, that looks better. So the next thing we're going to do is to install the weather effect. So let's go and say panel preferences, items, and we have weather effect here, and close and close, and move it over here, add the properties. Change the location. So let's get the size correct for this icon, the network manager. This is actually the system tray. It's called Status Tray plugin. Oh, there it again. Big L. I guess that's good now. Okay, so let's go ahead and configure the clock. We'll put on properties and we'll compare it with the clock in Commander. And we see here right away we have a time zone. Take it over. There are some differences in Debian 12 compared to Debian 11. Let's see. A digital tooltip format. There we use a custom format. Let's go custom. Paste it here. Clock options. Date and time. Now we want time and date. Okay. So here, it is all in one line, so we will take this part, which is the time, and we paste it here, and then we'll take this part, which is the date, and paste it like that. Yep, that is, I believe, the same as in Commodore Linux. Good. We do not use this Power Manager applet. So we will just remove it from now. It can be in System Tray. That's where it will be. Like that. Okay. We will get back to that later. So we'll remove it from here. And then we also don't use this one. So we'll remove this as well. And then the last thing we are missing is this button, which is for showing the desktop. And we want to add, and that is a regular launcher. Add, close, then we can edit it here, and let's see. Oh yeah, we need some special configuration files for this. Let's see how we did it here. Launcher. Desktop, edited. Yeah, it is running a special script here. Okay. And it uses this icon. Wait, let's see. Add a new empty item. We'll call it show desktop. And we won't give it any command yet. It will give the icon. Yeah, this one, show desktop. Okay. I can't create it yet. I need to give it a command. We'll give it the command that we are using in Commander. Copy that. Paste it here. And then I will create this file. Scan user local bin show desktop.sh. Okay. Create. Close. So now this one is here as well. Show desktop. If we click it, we get an error. Okay, wait, I'll fix that. So here on my local machine, I'll go to file system, user, and local bin. Show desktop. Let's open that and we'll take this and copy it. Then we'll go back to the virtual machine and let's open Sumer as we say pkexec Sumer. Then we'll go to file system, user, local bin. I'm going to create the file here. So, edit it. Paste that. Save. And see if it works now. No, because it's not executable. Check the properties here, permission. Allow this file to run as a program. I think that's what is missing. Property permission program. Let's return now. Oh, I see what it is. It is this. We don't have VM control. So we need to install VM control. And there we go. Let's close. Let's check again. There you go, it works. By the way, you might be asking yourself, what is this VM control? So at any time, you can go into a terminal and you can type man for manual, then the name of the program, like vmctl. And then here it will explain everything about the program. VM control is a command that can be used to interact with an X window manager that is compatible with the EWMH/NetWM specification. VM control can query the window manager for information and it can request the certain window management action to be taken. So that's a very handy tool to learn. Okay, let's finalize this weather plugin. But because we are missing the degrees here, and also our forecast here is 5 days, I think it's a bit too much. This forecast like 2 days in Commander, and also the pop-up is very simple in Commander, while it is rather complex here in Debian. So let's go to properties, appearance, tooltip style, simple. Just like that. And then number of days of forecast, just two. Just like that. And then let's get the temperature as well. That is here. And we can add different things, like temperature, like that. And that's it. One last thing regarding the clock. The font is too small, so we'll go in here. Changes from 8 to 10, and here from 8 to 10. So the last thing we're going to do in this video is that we're going to clean up in the menu here, and also add the shortcuts that are here. In order to do that, we need to have this application installed. So let's go and install it now. And it's called Menu Libre. So let's see now if we right click on the start button. Oh, I think we need to log in and log out. Let's try that. Yeah, now it's there. And we'll go to settings. And we'll say hide from menus. Then we'll click save. And there you go. That was no longer here. And then what we are going to do is, because this one has the wrong icon, I will say edit application, and we'll change it here to folder, this one, okay. Save, oh, it looks a bit more like Commander, then we'll control and left click and drag. We'll put it down here, create launcher. Next, we don't have Chrome yet, so we're just going to put control and left click. And then I put this one. And we have and so we don't have GIMP yet, so let's just install that real quick. Then we'll take GIMP, pull it down, and place it there. And finally, move the volume to the left side of the system tray. And that concludes this video. Next time, we're going to install the system theme so that the taskbar and the start menu will look a lot better, as well as the apps will have a proper window decorations. So thank you for watching and stay free.